became not just an athlete, but a world-class and kind of transcendent cultural figure. A lot of what my book is about, and a lot of what Iverson is known for now, is kind of what's happened since he stopped playing. He was not only a world-class basketball player, he was a world-class drinker. Drunk enough a lot of the times, and this is, you know, sad, that he missed the birth of a second child. Like I said, he refused to sleep and work out. He just didn't lift weights, just refused to do it. He was a little guy, screamed at his coach, you know, and just would not be corralled. And he'd still go out there and score 45 points a night. He would beat some of the biggest players in the game, and I mean that figuratively and literally. Crossing over Michael Jordan became legendary in urban America just because their guy was able to do this to this sort of suburban friendly superstar. He dedicated a game to the late Philadelphia sports writer who had years earlier challenged Iverson to clean up his act and reach his potential. These are the kind of people that he loved, that he just couldn't get away from, that he was as intrigued by as they were of him.